This video is sponsored by Skillshare. I got a new toy. This is a Horizon 202. A Russian swing lens film camera that shoots panoramas. It's pretty cool. I'm gonna go test it out today with a friend of mine who also has a panorama camera. One that is a lot more expensive. We're gonna go wide today.
So I have my Hasselblad XPan 2. This is a panoramic camera that can be able to shoot normal 135 and in panoramic mode. So I know this camera is very expensive now, but I bought and sold this camera multiple times. And I first bought it in 2011 at about only $12,000. But in the end, I bought back this XPan 2 because this is a really special camera. To me, this is not a daily camera that you will use it every day because of the format. But every time when you look at the photos and you scroll back the trips that you went, like what I had in Cuba, you will want to try this camera again. And I think it is a camera that everyone has to try if you shoot 135 film. So today my setup is Hasselblad XPan 2 with the 35 field finder. So this is a field finder specially designed for the 35mm lens, and this is a 35 f/5.6 lens with a centigrade filter. So with this lens, with a centigrade filter, you will offset the vignette in your photos. Thank you. Today we are shooting with a Reflex Lab 400D film, and this film is actually a motion picture film designed to shoot under daylight. And it is quite similar to CineSteel film because both of them are removed ramjet, so meaning that you can process it directly with C41 process. So there are two tips for everyone to shoot with the Reflex Lab 400D. The first one is the highlight, because this film has removed ramjet, so the highlight will be easily overblown because of the halation. The second part is the temperature. If you want a warmer tone, shoot this film during sunset time, because if you shoot it during the day, this will look kind of cool in color tone.
The XPan is nice, huh? Before I get to my camera, let's talk a bit about this video sponsor, Skillshare. When I started this whole YouTube thing, I had no idea what I was doing. I remember randomly discovering Skillshare through a Google search when I was desperately trying to learn more about color grading. To my surprise, there were a ton of other classes on Skillshare that suited my needs. Classes like Fred Trevino's Creating a Cinematic Look, Marcus Brownlee's Course on YouTube Success, and Craig Whitehead's Street Photography Compositions. I was able to extract knowledge from these creators to help make my channel feel a bit more polished and professional. If you're interested in joining Skillshare, they are now offering a promotion for my subscribers. The first 1,000 of you to use the link will get a 30-day free trial of Skillshare. This is a great way to get inspired and learn new skills. Explore your creativity with Skillshare today. Now let's talk about my camera. Like I said in the beginning of the video, the Horizon is a toy. Especially when compared to a camera like the Hasselblad XPan. It is, however, one of the cheapest ways to get into panoramas. The Horizon is capable of taking really high quality photos. But at this price point, it does come with a ton of limitations. First off, the lens is permanently focused to infinity. Fine for landscapes, but if you want anyone in the foreground, you'll need to go f11 or f16. There are only a few shutter speeds to choose from, 6 to be exact. So pairing the right film speed to your shooting conditions becomes a lot more important. My copy also has a light leak in the front element. Once I advance the film, light will start seeping in. I have to be quick with the shot, or else I'll end up with two washed out lines on both ends of the photo. The last one I can think of is how difficult it is to load, advance, and rewind your film. This camera can snap your film if you're not careful. Everything feels tight and sticky once you have your film loaded. I have to advance and rewind very carefully when I shoot with it. I thought I snapped my film on the shoot with Anson. I had to open the back to make sure and ended up losing a couple frames because of it. Despite its flaws, I love using the horizon. The moment you look through its ultra-wide viewfinder, you're invited to a completely different perspective. The way you're forced to hold it is awkward. You look like a child holding a camera for the first time. And the sound of the swing lens makes me giggle inside every time I press the shutter. Shooting film for me these days is all about experimentation and fun. If I'm going to be paying this much for film, I want the experience to be worth it. I want it to feel completely different from what I'm used to. It needs to be an enjoyable challenge. The Horizon 202 does that for me. When it comes to panoramic cameras, the Hasselblad XPan is king. Everything about it feels premium. It's trustworthy and provides you with all the tools you'll need to create stunning panoramic images. If you can afford the XPan, get it. But if you can't, you might want to take a look at the Horizon 202. It's far from perfect, but it's a really fun camera to use.